my young brothers and sisters, friends, it's indeed a rare privilege and honor to be amidst the leaders of the future like you people in these holy portals. It's a rare phenomenon that a great personality like Swami Vivekananda, whom I've been adoring from my childhood, ever existed in human history. In fact, Swamiji was not a personality. He was a phenomenon in human history. In fact, it will be difficult perhaps for your generation, even for my generation, to understand under what circumstances he espoused the cause of this great nation and great human race. You know, a great civilization, perhaps when the Westerners did not know how to wear clothes, India was a great civilization. We knew pi value. We held very intense discourses in intrinsic philosophical concepts. So many things were happening in ancient India. Such a great nation, such a great civilization. What happened to that nation? What happened to that civilization? It got subjugated by a tiny country called Britain. Indians lost self-esteem. Indians became pauperized. Indians were not having, majority of the Indians were not having enough food to eat. There was famine everywhere. There was poverty everywhere. There was ignorance everywhere. It stirred him. In fact, I consider Swami Vivekananda to be not a simple spiritual leader. He was a great rational human being. Today, we are talking about leadership qualities. As youngsters, I would advise you to learn a few things from the life of Swami Vivekananda, the teachings of Swami Vivekananda, the great work he had done for this country in particular and for humanity in general. A few items, because it's basically a leadership issue, okay? You're all future leaders. I would discuss, I try to correlate how he analyzed the society at his time, the problems of his particular generation, okay? And how we try to correlate a few things. And from there, let us see how we emerge as the future leaders of mankind. The most important thing, the first and foremost, Swamiji firmly believed was open-mindedness. Unlike many other religious people, he was not believing in whatever was told to him. Everything that he read, everything that was told to him, he was reflecting over it again and again. Okay? On the one side, the theoretical knowledge which he was acquiring because of his voracious reading, okay, from a very young age. On the other hand, he was going around the country, different corners of the country, seeing the problems himself. What happened actually, why these people are like this? And then he went around the world with his contemporary intellectuals. He was discussing the issues and then arrived at a solution. First he identified the problem, then he identified and critically analyzed the causes for the problem, then he arrived at a solution. He understood that such a great country had become pauperized, had become an ignorant country, basically because of the poverty of the masses. He was the first social reformer in medieval India, okay, to understand the link, the direct link between economic prosperity, economic well-being and the spiritual well-being. He was the one who established a contact between the two, analyzed. With that, he arrived at a solution that unless and until we emancipate the vast humanity of masses, the vast masses of this country from poverty, from ignorance, there is no future for this country. He arrived at the conclusion. Understanding the importance of this, then he said, on the one hand, we require temporal education, education that is required for upliftment of all these vast masses for their day-to-day living. So, if you are farmers, you shall be taught how to do agriculture in a better manner, how to till the land in a better manner so that the land gives more yield, and people who did not have food at that time, actually there was massive famine. You would have heard of, you know, see, those famous famines those days actually. So the yield of the land, you know, the agriculture would improve. And any other profession they were indulging in, actually you should modernize Indian professions with the traditional knowledge and the modern knowledge that was coming from the Western countries, because by then industrial revolution had taken place, the Renaissance, cultural Renaissance had taken place in the Western countries. So he was the one who was able to marry these two concepts. Then, courage of conviction was the most important thing that Swamiji followed. Once you believe that you are doing the right thing, there is no looking back. Okay? You have identified the cause, the right cause you have identified. Having identified the right cause, actually see, you have the courage of conviction that what you are trying to do for the vast human beings actually living in poverty in this country, actually, you have nothing to fear. Okay? Let temporarily the British subjugate us, nothing would happen. But ultimately, India would emerge as a victorious nation. He had the belief that sowed the seeds of actually freedom movement in this country. Slowly, slowly you had seen so many national leaders had emerged, actually, Gandhiji people, all these people. They were all products of the philosophy that was taught by Swami Vivekananda. Then, after that, what are the other issues? Today, as our friend is pointing out, actually, there is a deterioration in the value system. There was a deterioration in the value system at that particular time. There is a deterioration in the value system now. So, we shall be able to identify what are the problems that are causing trouble in the present society. Then, you shall arrive at proper solution. Not a simple solution. There is also a requirement for spiritual knowledge, the better value system. Be good to people. Do good to everybody, then automatically the result will come. You shall not hanker after, okay, as leaders, if you want to become leaders, don't hanker after money, don't hanker after wealth, don't hanker after fame, don't hanker after recognition. Money and recognition, fame, etc., these shall be the byproducts of what exactly you are doing for humankind. All of us are privileged. How many of you are from English medium education? Please raise your hands. Okay. Majority of you are from English medium education. How many of you are from good public schools or private schools? Okay. Not government schools. Okay. Many of you. Okay. See, we are the privileged lot of the society. We are less than 1% of Indian population. Okay? Majority of the Indian population do not have access to proper sanitary facilities. They live in slums in both urban and rural areas. They do not have access to proper education. Whereas when compared to that, all of us are privileged lot, actually. All of us are able to study in English medium and get better jobs, etc. Think of your brethren, majority of your sisters and brothers, they are living in villages, they are living in slums, in urban areas. Think of them, how can they compete with you? It becomes very difficult. So, on the one hand, you try to excel in your studies, in the competitive examinations which you have to appear in future, and whatever profession you choose, you shall try to excel, but at the same time, please keep it in mind that you will have to help your underprivileged friends, underprivileged brothers and sisters who don't have the same access which you have, okay, to better education. If you are able to give a helping hand to the majority, the vast majority who do not have the same access, then automatically you become better human beings. Ultimately, what is life? Okay. If I join, somebody was mentioning that actually, see, I'm not an entrepreneur, I am a government officer. Okay. We have started this project. You would have heard of Hyderabad Metro Rail Project. How many of you have heard of Hyderabad Metro Rail Project? Many of you have heard. This is the world's largest public-private partnership project. This is the world's largest mass transit system, metro rail project, being executed in public-private partnership. There are 200 metro rail projects in the world. Out of the 200 metro rail projects, a majority of them are built by governments with government money, that is with taxpayers' money. When I was dreaming about Hyderabad also should have a metro rail project, actually, we did not have the funds. We in government did not have the money to, because it's a huge project. At the time, we estimated the project cost as 12,000 crore rupees. We did not have this kind of funds. Then I thought about, why not do it with private investment as a public-private partnership? At the time, only the concept of PPP was coming into this country. People laughed at me. They said, oh, what foolish thing he's talking about, and MSRD is talking about. When nobody has done it in the world, how can he do it? Then, those who were saying that it would not work, it would fail, you can't build a public transport system of this magnitude, a huge metro rail project in private sector with private sector funds, okay, because nobody has done it in the world. My question to them was very simple. Before Wright brothers, did any human being fly in the sky? No human being was flying in the sky. Before Yuri Gagarin, did any human being go into space? No, nobody. Before Neil Armstrong, did any human being set foot on moon? No. Okay. Does it mean that the human history would stop with those things? Actually, just because nobody has done it, does it mean that we will not even attempt? I said, no, that's wrong. Actually, let me attempt. Let me show to the world that India is capable of doing things differently. Okay. And let me prove to the world that India is capable of having this kind of knowledge, this kind of talent. This is how we started. Initially, we failed. This is again very important. When you raise your bar, okay, when you are aiming, you are in your class, okay, you are aiming that actually say, okay, I should be in the first 20, first 10, it's okay. Then you slowly increase it, say that I want to be number one in the class. Then you slowly, you are raising the bar, okay? Then why? I should be number one in the district or in the city. I shall be number one in the state. I shall be number one in the country, okay? As you keep on increasing your bar, actually. Be prepared for failure, okay? Because it happens that actually, see, when, as long as you know a goal is achievable, it becomes very easy. We strive hard, we achieve it. But the moment you are increasing your goals, actually, be prepared for failure. People will ridicule you. People will laugh at you. That, this girl or boy said that actually she would be the topper, okay, of this school, the topper of this city, the topper of this state, etc. See what happened. She is nowhere in the list. He is nowhere in the list. This kind of thing comes. Be prepared for that. Nothing will happen. Again, you try, you will become successful. This is what has happened, actually. When the first time Hyderabad Metro experiment failed, okay, People were laughing at us, people were throwing stones at us, people were cracking jokes on us. We did not get disheartened. This is what is required. Courage of conviction. That's what Swamiji taught us, actually. Once you have the courage of conviction, automatically the success is yours. Automatically the world will recognize that you are the hero, that you are the leader. Okay? The rest will follow you. This, again, this is not for one-upmanship. This is not for showing off. This is basically, we have to give something back to our motherland, to our country. Our country does not have resources today. So, it is up to us using innovation. This is again Swamiji's another great contribution to Indian philosophy and Indian thinking. He always advocated, don't go by, see, rotten path, I see. To follow the rut is very easy. But if you are having a path-breaking approach, you have to be innovative in your conceptual thinking. You have to be innovative in the practices you follow. So for that, what is required? Tremendous self-discipline. Unless and until you are disciplined personally, you will not be a leader. Okay? If I do not work beyond the office hours, if I do not work on holidays, people say that he is mad actually all the time. And he is in office actually. Saturday he is there, Sunday he is there, night he is there. If I am not there in my office, how can I expect my colleagues to be, my followers, sinners, my subordinates to be in office? I cannot sit at home, enjoy, and say that, look, all of you people work because it's a huge project. Okay? Nobody in the world has done a project of this magnitude in such a short time with private sector investment. So, all of you work hard, I'll enjoy it. Home. No, it will not work. You shall live by example. Okay? That's what strict discipline, all of you would have read a lot and lot about Swami Vivekananda's life history. That's how he became a great personality. Then, with all these things, you shall have communication skills, the most important thing. Okay? Not many knew about Swami Vivekananda. Okay? Till he went to which place?
Chicago.
Okay? Parliament of World Religions. Because by then he was formulating his ideas. Okay? He was accumulating knowledge from different streams, both from the ancient traditional Indian texts and also from the Western philosophy. Okay? He was formulating his ideas, but the world did not recognize him. So, he made use of the opportunity that knocked at his door, or in fact, he went and knocked at that door, because nobody invited him also. Okay? He volunteered on himself actually, somehow his friends helped him, okay, finance him to go. Those days it was very difficult actually to travel abroad. And then, the moment he spoke, that wonderful speech he made, actually, the whole world got mesmerized. Yes, here is a person, an ordinary monk, actually, normally the kind of contempt Westerners had till then for Indians was unimaginable, you can't think of, actually, see. These were half-pucket, half-naked pucket, this is the language they used to use, actually, see. Okay? Because Indians did not, they were not even wearing clothes properly, they were not covering their bodies properly. This was the image Westerners had at the time. He completely changed that image actually. The moment he saw, he was a person actually. See, he was glowing, his face was glowing, his clothes were completely, they were amazed actually by the very aura, the presence of Swamiji actually, the way he spoke actually. So this is the most important thing. All of you shall develop communication skills, okay? You shall be able to communicate, and again, what is your audience is the most important thing. If you are talking to scientists, speak to them in the language of scientists. Okay? If you are talking to ordinary people, speak to them in their language so that they understand. Again, Hyderabad Metro, initially it was coming under attack from different segments of society, okay, the so-called intellectuals. Then I was engaging them in a debate at different levels. Okay, let's argue which system is good. If it is engineers, in engineers language I was speaking. If it is environmentalist, in environmentalist language I was speaking. So if you are social scientists, in social scientist language I was speaking. But the most important thing is the majority. Who are the majority? They are the ordinary people who do not understand English language. So what I did was, I wrote poetry in Telugu, actually the folk songs, and then released it to the city. That people lapped it up, actually they appreciated. Yes, this is the thing we understood, actually. See, in common man's language, we wrote about the entire philosophy, the entire scientific things behind this particular project, actually, in ordinary language, in ordinary Telugu, and that's how we distributed. These are just a few examples, some things. So we have to learn, actually, see, from great personalities of history like Swami Vivekananda, Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose, and all these things, and the present leaders like, say, Abul Kalam Azad, then the present A.P.J. Kalam, the other day C.N.R. Rao, actually he became Bharat Ratna. The person whose slog for 60 years, not many knew about him actually. But we have seen the other day Bharat Ratna actually was conferred on him, such a great scientist he was. Okay? So don't bother about recognition, don't bother about fame, etc. Automatically these things will come to you, provided you identify the right thing, right cause, do the right thing, have courage of conviction, and you are able to communicate to the majority of the people in the language which they understand. I don't want to take much of your time. I know all of you are more capable of doing things in a better way when compared to our generation, when compared to me. Your younger generation is a smarter generation, more literate, you have more knowledge, you have more access to knowledge. Okay? So keep your minds open, don't simply follow. I will quote what my grandfather, okay, a semi-literate person, a farmer, used to tell me in Telugu. Vinadagun evvaru cheppina vininantana vega padaka vivarimpadagun. Understand this? Vinadagun evvaru cheppina, if anybody says anything, listen to him first. Okay? And then, first, many people, you know, we are close-minded, you know, we think that actually we know more than them. But we don't even listen. Don't do that. First listen to them. But just because somebody said something, don't blindly believe. Okay? You shall reflect whether what he said is correct or not, actually. If he says, if you feel that actually what he said is correct, okay, after your, that's what actually your viveka, vivechana, that is your capability of reflecting over a particular thing, then arrive at your own conclusion, and having come to that conclusion, if you believe that that's the right conclusion, then go ahead into action. Ultimately, every idea shall have to be translated into action. Once it is translated into action, the results will be seen for the entire mankind, it will be seen by everybody. So, with this small message, I wish you all the very best. And I congratulate all the winners. At the same time, those who have not won, don't get disappointed. You will get another opportunity. You will definitely win. You will all become leaders. And I also thank this great institution which has given me this opportunity, which is nurturing the young minds, which is molding the nation. In fact, the nation is made in portals like this. I am very grateful to you. I humbly submit that all of you shall work hard and let us make our country a great country. Thank you very much.